airline passengers at 5 airports right here. Overseas, the UK is sending 750 troops to Sierra Leone to help build an Ebola treatment center. And the World Bank warns the economic cost of the virus could exceed $32 billion. So part of that airport screening process we mentioned will involve checking temperatures of passengers arriving from infected countries in West Africa. The screenings will take place at Hartsfield-Jackson, Atlanta, Newark, JFK, Washington Dulles, and Chicago O'Hare. Ken Jenkins is an aviation crisis consultant and is my guest. Ken, these announcements have just come out that apparently these 5 airports, this is where the screenings are going to take place, screenings for temperatures, and apparently 150 people a day at these airports will be screened. Is that the right measure to be taking?
And good afternoon, Gretchen. I do think it is the right measure to be taken at this point. The public wants to have some kind of information in terms of how the airline industry is going to be taking care of Ebola, and this is one of the measures that they can do that by.
But 150 people a day, if I'm doing the math in my head, let's say 250 are on an airplane, that's just one airplane. So of all the flights coming into JFK, for example, they're only going to look at 150 people. You're an expert at this. Is that what you would advise to them, and how do they come up with a number like that?
Well, I hadn't seen the number, and quite honestly, the number seems relatively low to me, but those are the 5 busiest international airports in the United States. And with the flights being checked, if they're coming from the Africa region, for example, or the areas impacted the most by Ebola, I would think the numbers would be higher. I think it's important to note, though, not only are these 5 airports going to do that, the screening, airports around the United States do this kind of screening on a routine basis today. They're already observing for passengers that might show signs of illness to see if there's any type of treatment that they might need, particularly when you're looking at something like when we had bird flu years ago,
right,
or SARS or something like that. So they're already adept at being able to do this.
All right, so you're a crisis consultant. What are you telling?
Ma'am.
What are you telling airlines right now about actually the safety of passengers inside airplanes with pilots and with flight attendants, et cetera?
Well, and what I share with airlines are what I've learned through my 30 years in aviation and what I've seen through the airlines that I've worked with. And it's, first of all, education of your frontline employees and your flight crews, including your flight attendants and pilots. What most major carriers in the United States do through the flight attendant and the frontline employees are, if you observe somebody that shows signs of illness, let's say, for example, Gretchen, on an actual airplane, then you take the symptoms that you're observing, you bring that information to the attention of the cockpit crew, who then talks to the airline dispatch. And when through dispatch, they're going to work with their medical team, whether it's somebody on site with the airline,
right,
or through a medical vendor, and then determine if, when that flight arrives, whether or not it needs to be met by paramedics, CDC employees, or local Department of Health, depending on where the aircraft is landing.
I know, Ken, it sounds like a lot of responsibility for people who are just trying to fly people safe, and now they got to be worrying about Ebola. But that's why you're in the business that you're in. Ken Jenkins, thank you for your thoughts. So, what about the family now of Thomas Eric Duncan?